Who do you kind of look at and kind of follow and say, man, I like that guy, I like that fighter?
Triple G. Triple G, because I was able to spend some time with him up in
Big Bear. Oh, you went to Big Bear, right? Yeah.
With my nephew. He's talented, you know. Pacquiao. Because Ellie, I said that because of Ellie.
Pacquiao's cool. Oh. He's a good guy. He's really cool. Why are you laughing, Ricky?
I like Mikey Garcia's an exciting fighter.
He's a monster.
He's a monster. I look up to him. Who else? There's, man, so many fighters
that
could name.
Canelo.
Don't listen to this guy.
Chavez Jr.
No, Canelo is a good fighter. Abner Morris. There's so many fighters.
Vanes. Who do you want to see Vanes fight next? Because he just had a big victory over Willie Nelson. 154. Cotto, Canelo.
I would like him to see Cotto. Cotto or a rematch with Lara. That would be good. Rematch with, what's his name? Andre... The one who he lost to?
Who? Who did?
Vanes.
Andrade.
Demetrius Andrade. That would be a good rematch for him. But right now the Goosen family is looking to put him up in a good spot, a good big fight.
And just for me, Dan Goosen, I know it affected a lot of people, man. You've been so close to the Goosen family. I mean, how was that for you? Even now, thoughts? I mean, what were your initial thoughts when you heard about it? Just your thoughts now?
Yeah. It was hard because I was there in the hospital right before his passing. I was there with him. And one thing, he knows that I love putting pictures up on the Instagram and Facebook.
I see him all the time.
All the time. He goes to me, Ricky, do not put nothing up. Don't say nothing. And I got a phone call from a lot of people. Rich Marotta is one of them because Rich Marotta was really close to Dan. And I go, Rich, I'm sorry. I promise Dan I would not say anything. I know you heard something, but that's the way it goes. I can't say anything because that was a promise. So, you know, it's tough because I look at his pictures. We were just in Puerto Rico and together, you know. And he'll be missed.
What's your favorite moment with Dan Goosen throughout your career as a trainer, fighter, as a kid?
It was, 1993 when we were in Big Bear when Gabriel Rafael was fighting.
21 years ago.
He was in a fight for the world title, Rafael, against Freddie Pendleton. And it was our last day in training camp. And, shit. Put me on the spot there, man.
It was tough, man.
Yeah. But he will be missed.
Yeah, he had his SL 500 on Mercedes, and Bichia and Debbie were driving me down to my house, which was pretty cool. You know, that was one of the first times that I was able to talk with him on the way down. I was young, I was a kid, so.
There you have it, Ricky Funez.
Hey, Ricky, one more time, man, to get you back.
Back.
What do you think is fighting?